Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. I'm a real-world Airbus captain, and today we're going to be exploring another interesting feature of the Airbus, and that's ground speed mini. The ground speed mini function helps pilots maintain the right level of energy in the aircraft during approaches, especially in variable wind conditions, ensuring a smooth and safe landing. But how does that work? So let's run through that. This video does follow on nicely of that of the last, where we looked at approach speed management, discussing the VLS check and how the app is calculated and used. Ground speed mini is a function that only works when you're in managed speed and only works on final approach, so it's not affecting any other of the familiar Airbus speed sets that you know, such as green dot speed or anything like that. It's only a function of a final approach. Ground speed mini will adjust our magenta triangle speed targets, which we'll see shortly as we turn in for our approach, and to take into account the headwind component and the gusts. So what's important here is we have the correct tower wind in. So this is our current, we're coming into Gothenburg shortly, runway 21. This is our tower wind, only 200 at 10. Now, ground speed mini will be looking at the headwind components of that wind and comparing that to our current wind. So the ideas will be sensing what our current wind is and making calculations looking into the variance between the two. So it's really important to have an accurate tower wind in there to ensure ground speed mini adjusts the level of energy in the aircraft appropriately. So we're currently downwind and we have a tailwind of 34 knots, but we're expecting to turn into that tailwind, so we'll have a strong headwind component as we turn in. That's going to decrease to 10 knots for touchdown, so we're going to be losing energy from the aircraft. So there's a good 30 knots or so of energy thereabouts to come out. So obviously headwind is airflow over the wing, so that's helpful, that is energy in the aircraft, which we'll lose. And big and sudden drops of wind, especially headwind, can be quite dangerous. So we can, if we're at VF plus 5 knots, which is sort of a normal situation in low wind and where we would be targeting without ground speed mini, if that wind suddenly dropped off, we would be in a dangerous speed situation and we would likely to drop below lowest selectable speed at least. So it is a safety feature, and it does help us maintain a better level of energy in those changing conditions where we may see sudden drops of energy. And in this case today, we're expecting to see the energy come out of the aircraft as we descend, which does happen. Sometimes we can have 70 knots at the start of approach at altitude, and it can be a lot lower on the ground. So it's quite rare to have such extremes, but it does happen, and it is something I have experienced in the real world quite a few occasions. So just to understand how ground speed mini calculates, it works out a minimum energy value, and to do that it takes our VAP speed, so what's been calculated here as VAP, which is VLS plus 5 based on the current conditions. And it would subtract the tower reported headwind component from the app. So let's say that's wind is pretty much down the runway. It's going to be looking at, so we've got 146 as the app. So a minimum energy, which ground speed mini would be working from, it will be around about 136 knots. What's ground speed mini targets on the primary flight display with the magenta triangle, which will move around according to the changing winds, is the greater of either our VAP speed or the calculated value of ground speed mini plus the current headwind component. So as we turn on to the approach at this altitude, currently we're expecting at least 34 knots of headwind, and it's going to add that headwind component to the lowest minimum energy that we've calculated previously from VAP minus tower headwind, So it'll be 136 plus, you know, around 34 knots. And that will change as that wind changes. And that, so you'll see a much higher VAP target here on the approach initially. And that's to maintain energy to account for that strong headwind. Without ground speed mini, what you'll see is a lot more variation in adjustment of engine power. So it will constantly be adjusting to deal with gusts up and down, rather than trying to maintain that constant energy in the aircraft. So it's a lot more stable. As it only works in managed speed, one thing to be wary of is where we get speed restrictions. So we may get a restriction of maintain 160 knots to 4 DME, for example, on approach. It's quite common. In which case, we'd have to pull selected speed and dial that in, and we'll then lose that energy buffer provided by ground speed mini. Now at 4 DME, when you want to revert back to and start reducing speed back from 160 to approach speed, if you went managed there and the wind difference was still quite high, you're going to see a lot of energy suddenly be put back into the aircraft, which can destabilize your approach somewhat. So just before you go managed speed, if you're using selected speed for restrictions on final approach, just be wary of the expected difference which ground speed mini can cause going from selected to managed after you pass your restriction point. That's just one to watch. Ground speed mini will not command an overspeed, and it will go to flap extension speed plus 5 knots maximum. So let's unpause the sim. Bring the aircraft round into Gothenburg's runway 21. So you see we've got a crosswind now, 38 knots, and that's going to soon become a headwind for us. Rockstar. I'm going to go with flaps 2 now, and we're going to select, bring the speed back a little bit. A little bit early so we can start to see the effect of ground speed mini wants to do. So we've got our magenta triangle. Currently targeting 170. Lock. Yeah, our VAP is 145, targeting 170. This is where you start to see differences around. I quite often get the question, why is my aircraft not following my VAP speed? I'm too fast, and this is what it is. So that's the aircraft is constantly measuring that wind, comparing it to the tower reported headwind component, and adjusting that magenta triangle accordingly. We've got 35 knots on the nose, that's 195 degrees, so pretty much a straight headwind. Now we expect that to reduce to 10 knots for landing, so quite a big energy change in the aircraft, which could be problematic. Glide slope star if we were close to our VLS, our lowest selectable speed, which is indicated by the top of the yellow bar there, which is 150 knots currently. You don't see ground speed mini as a a readout anywhere. It's only represented by that magenta triangle. Go gear down. Glide slope and flaps free. Speed checks, flaps free. So we're holding about 179 knots now. Remember that VAP for VLS plus 5 was 145, so around about there. So that's the difference. There's a fair difference there. So 33 knots on the nose currently. We'll go flaps full, speed checks, flaps full. You see it's holding us there at about 168, 169 knots at the ground speed mini. So wind's 32 knots, 31, so it's decreasing. You'll see the magenta target start to come down as it takes into account that decreasing wind. About 165 knots now, 30 knots on the nose. I'll take the autopilot out and I'll hand fly at him using auto thrust, so we maintain that energy. So about 160. One, my control. Dropping, see the magenta target dropping now. 158 as that wind comes down. 23 knots on the nose now. Maintaining that difference, constantly looking right at that difference of headwind component to our minimum calculated energy, which ground speed minis take into account. Continue. So yeah, it's about 146 knots there as we touched down, so it brought that back down right sort of to the VAP. Spoilers, diesel. 70 knots. So you can see that did a really good job of maintaining energy in the aircraft. If we were there at VLS plus 5 and we lost that 30 knots of wind very suddenly, or we had a big gust and it dropped off, it could have put the aircraft in a more dangerous situation in terms of speed management. The aircraft will take into account gusts, it will sense those coming over the aircraft and the direction, so it's constantly looking at those. I would just keep the energy on and sort of increase the energy if required to deal with those. But it's a really useful system. It's not designed to deal with crosswind, so it's all because crosswind doesn't really affect aircraft energy. It affects angle of approach and it is unstabilizing in that sense, but crosswinds don't really take energy out of the aircraft. The headwind and the headwind gusts, which and the sudden changes in those, which can take the energy out. So that's what ground speed mini is designed for. It's a really useful Airbus feature. It's not available on all aircraft, so it's not something you find everywhere. So it's one to get used to. And that kind of example we've run through here today is where ground speed mini works best. I will put those sort of ground speed mini calculations into the video description, and they're also on screen, as you'll see early in the video, so you can just have a look at those. And just be wary of that speed restriction situation we discussed earlier on the approach, as that's one way it can catch you out a little bit if you put managed speed back in and there's still a big variation between your current wind and tower reported wind. Any questions on that, please drop them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer them. And please check out the channel membership as well, where members get early access to the latest content as it comes through, along with a few other perks. Thanks for watching and take care. Thank you.